In this video, we're going to shed light on one of economics's various subdisciplines, behavioural economics. For more content like this from INOMICS, the site for economists, be sure to hit subscribe. Behavioural economics is commonly understood to stand at the intersection between psychology and economics, and those who practice it explore how people make economic decisions and why their behaviour does not always follow the predictions of traditional economic models. Increasingly popular in the past few decades, behavioural economics mounts a challenge to the classical economic assumption that people always act rationally to maximise their own utility or outcomes. Because, when you think about it, it's pretty obvious that people do not always act straightforwardly to maximise their own benefits. People can act emotionally, selflessly, or simply have neither the information to make fully informed decisions or the ability to balance multiple different inputs in real time. The concept of rationality itself is subjective. This word rational does a lot of heavy lifting for all manner of ideological, political, and moral assumptions. Behavioural economics, therefore, uses aspects of psychology to better understand how and why people actually make the economic decisions they do, not just assume they act narrowly out of individual self-interest and maximisation. One commonly noted phenomenon in behavioural economics is loss aversion. Loss aversion is where people place greater value on avoiding losses than on attaining potential gains and make decisions accordingly. This knowledge has been used by companies to offer potential customers free trials. Free trials take advantage of an individual's tendency to opt into a service when it is free. As the service becomes incorporated into their lives, the sense of loss of not having it makes them more likely to purchase the full service, even if they may not have done so if required to buy upfront. How offers and incentives are framed generates a psychological and behavioural response. Understanding these responses is the bread and butter of behavioural economics. However, at its core, what is economics if it's not about the behaviour of individuals and organisations? The distinction between what is and isn't considered behavioural economics, as opposed to economics more broadly, is not necessarily very great. Want to find out more? Head to INOMICS' term section, including economic definitions in German, Italian and Spanish, or hit subscribe for more top economics content. And the next time you're looking for an economics degree programme, job, online course or conference, be sure to head over to INOMICS.com, the site for economists.